there are hundreds of listed companies facing bankruptcy where the existing shareholders are expected to get a raw deal. The new promoter or the successful bidders are bringing in fresh equity that will give them a majority control in these companies. The existing shareholders will get reduced to minority in these companies. Take for example in the case of Electrosteel, you know, one of the 12 companies that was referred to bankruptcy by RBI in June last year. The Vedanta, which is a successful bidder in Electrosteel, has brought in some 1,800 crore of fresh equity. Now that 800 crore of fresh equity is giving Vedanta a 90% stake in Electrosteel. The existing equity, which is around 2,000 crore, will get reduced to 10%. So the existing shareholders of Electrosteel will get reduced to minority in the new setup. The focus of new promoter or the successful bidder in this company will be on the turnaround. In a stock exchange listing, there are a lot of disclosure requirement. So this promoter in future may go for, you know, delisting of share, you know, merger of these companies with a larger or a parent or a stronger company. They may also sell these businesses to some other investor, you know, in future. There are many rights of this minority shareholder under the Companies Act. First, the small shareholder director. There is a provision in the Companies Act for installing a small shareholder director who can take care of the minority interest. Recently, in one of the cases of Alembic Pharmaceutical, we have seen minority shareholder insisting on a small shareholder director, though the request of minority shareholder was rejected, but there is a provision in the Companies Act where you can install a small shareholder director who can take care of the interest of the minority shareholder in these companies. Second, operation and mismanagement. The minority shareholder also have a right to approach NCLT in case of any operation or mismanagement of the company that can relate to fund diversion or maybe a mismanagement in the affairs of the company. Third, delisting of shares. There is a strong possibility that the new promoter or the successful bidder will delist the company from the stock market. The promoter first has to acquire 90% of the shares from the market and then go for a delisting. The minority shareholder can challenge the pricing part if there is an issue there. Merger with the group companies. There is also a big possibility of merger of these companies with a group company or a stronger company. In such cases, the approval of the High Court is required. Again, the minority shareholder have a right to approach the court in case they feel that the merger or the pricing is not fair. Second, the independent valuer. Under the Companies Act, there is a provision that when the valuation is done, the company should appoint an independent valuer to decide the price. So in case the minority shareholder have any issue with the pricing, they can also question the pricing in the High Court or the NCLT. Finally, the sale of shares or the sale of company. The new promoter may decide in future to sell the company to some other investor. Again, minority shareholder have a right or they can approach to SEBI again in case they have any grievances.